Good morning, we're back at the President's Trophy Air Race. Nice weather today, thank goodness. And we're looking forward to a really nice race today.
Lovely. We're competing to win. I suppose the Sirius is always ahead and Rufus is going to come and give us a good race today. Rufus, what are you flying?
We're flying a B-33, a Beechcraft. And we've seen this orange machine many times, either just in front of us or just behind us. So it's going to be a tough race.
Lekker.
Okay, so here we are at Tempe.
Morning everyone.
Day two. And unfortunately yesterday was a total washout. But today it's looking promising. The skies are clearing and we're hoping for a
good race.
A really great race.
Well, last year we did fairly well, so hopefully we can do good today as well, since it's the only race day we're having today. Hope for the best.
And we're one of the father and son teams, so there are a few father and son teams, so we're going to do good.
I'm Jan Rijkassen from Kilo Alpha November here behind us, 1977 Vito. And excited after yesterday's rain and stuff. Maybe we're going to get a chance today. And hope all goes well and everything goes safe. And really looking forward to it. My navigator here.
I think it's going to be a good one. It's the first one, but I think we'll pull it through.
Son, and then my dad. He's also flying 77. He's flying with Effie. He's got 29,000 hours on already. And even my younger brother, they're competing against us. So it's a whole family thing.
My name is Duan, this is my navigator. This is our first beat off, and we would look forward to do another one next year. I came all the way from Whiteley, it's close to the Limpopo River, Whitebridge.
Yeah, I'm Peter, navigator for this T10. And yeah, let's see, it's our first air race. We're gonna maybe have a blast, maybe get lost along the way, but we're gonna enjoy it.
Okay, it's our first air race, 2022. We are ready for it, George?
Yes, of course. We're Stefan's come through from Postmansburg. I've come through from Hartswater, originally from the UK side, but we're ready for action. We're ready for action at New Tempe 2022. I've been here for 3 years now. I'm instructing at Fly School, Eagle Flight Academy in Hartswater, that side. So it's definitely a much more relaxed, enjoyable atmosphere. Braise, Brandewijn, all the rest of it is like it. And this is just the pinnacle.
Good.
Nice good old ex-military Bospop. We're gonna fly the hell out of it and see where we get. Hope the fuel lasts.
I've imported the best pilot in the world. Today we are doing a father and son, first time president, fourth time president. We're gonna win because we got the fastest, beautiful plane out here. And yeah, as I said, my pilot must just listen to me and then we'll make it.
Look, we've done this a couple of times. And as far as I'm concerned, the main thing is not to get lost, and that will be my mistake if we do. And then we won't be friends afterwards. So that's the biggest thing that I need to get right. And he's a good pilot, so then we've got to sort it.
So John, this is now, I understand, what did you say, 35th race?
My 35th race.
Today?
Today. I've only missed two.
That's wonderful. And tell me what you're going to do today.
We've got a plan. It's Dion's first state president's race. Jack Kutzer, you remember I used to fly with? Jack lives in Chicago now.
Okay. So John's traded down a little bit, but
not at all.
But I hope to add some value today, I hope. We got a top secret plan that we thought of last night.
Yeah.
We weren't drinking at all. We obviously just sat with the books and the maps the whole night, as we do. And then we've got a good plan.
But we went through the maps for yesterday's race. So it'll be turning into a nice day. We've got a reasonable handicap. So we hope to be in the first five. It's possible. As long as we find everywhere. No, that's the trick.
And John, as long as you don't run out of fuel.
No, I won't run out. It's a short race, 300 nautical miles.
And John, this beautiful plane, tell me a bit more about it.
We finished this aeroplane in, I think, 1989. Came from Mozambique. I bought it from Brian Zederberg.
Where did you finish it, John?
I think 92.
But where was that?
Tony Watson's place.
I was a little boy.
Yeah.
And we drove out there one day. And I mean, I was probably in high school. And that was still in a different colour scheme.
It was near Northgate.
Yeah.
Actually, it was rebuilt. In fact, it was what was interesting, funny about it, and I don't have a photograph, is that when I bought it from Brian Zederberg at Saferfontein, the wings were off and everything, and I got a garden trailer, and I hitched it to the back of my bucky, and I put the tailwheel in the back and towed it down the highway to Lanseria backwards. And I have no photographs, unfortunately. So, that's a wonderful aeroplane. This aeroplane is... it's really a good aeroplane.
It
flies straight. It's a fantastic aeroplane. Nice to race.
We're certainly going to give it our best today. It looks like we've got a nice flying weather today. We're flying today, so man, we're going to give it carrots today. Yeah, we were joint winners last year, and so we kind of set a bit of a precedent over there. So we're going to try and maintain our position.
Hey, good morning, guys. Myself and Quinton, we're the father-son team flying Foxtrot Victor Victor. It's a PA28-2C5. And for your information today, that's the winning aeroplane. So just watch when we come back, please. And we've got a sponsor, Beagle Track, sponsoring us. We say thank you to those guys. And we hope we do well today.
Well, today is the day. There was no day yesterday. It was rain. But today we're going for it. Take off first. It's my second PTAR. And... nice handicap. I think we can do well. We might just fly the route. Can't wait for it. Go for it, Lutz. Team Lutz.
So this is Sandy and I'm Richard, and what you see behind you is Sok. This is the second time I'm doing a PTAR. You've done it a few times more. Fantastic race, always is. And weather is good, believe it or not, after yesterday. And just gonna go out and have fun. Should be fantastic.
It was a lovely day today and we are going to hopefully win.
Excited to fly. Be a nice quick race. Weather's looking good, much better.
We guarantee to win.
We guarantee to come over the line first and the fastest.
Good day, Matthias Mare.
Hi, and I'm Stefan Lombard. We are piloting today this beautiful Piper Comanche. It's our second PTAR race. Looking forward. I think practice rounds is over. Today we're going to take it. We're not going to mess around. We're going to catch all the guys in front of us and. I reckon all the Bonnies and RVs behind us are not going to catch us, so we're going to have a good one.
Good morning.
Good morning. My name's Simon.
I'm Glenn, the navigator. He's so, the pilot.
And he's going to give us the last today, but we're going to have a huge amount of fun. RV, that's RV7. Our speed 165, so let's hope we can beat it.
Hello guys, this is Taryn and I'm Mike. And that's an RV8, and that's an amazing aeroplane. We are second fastest here today. We are going to kick some ass. Promise you, proper kick ass, you know? What do you have to say, Taryn? Are you going to nav for us nicely?
Absolutely. Can't wait. First time in the tandem. It's going to be very interesting, but can't wait. We're going to be passing some people.
Watch this space. We're going to pass a few oaks today. I can see that. Lucky we know the judges. We've had to Jippo and make plans. So we've got in there. So we made a special plan. So we should have a good odds today. Watch this one, you know?
That was a nice race. I think we just won it with 20, 30 meters, but absolutely nice.
Excellent flight. A bit of wind and I had to battle it, but it worked out well for us.
So it was kind of touch and go.
Touch and go.
No, it was definitely.
The navigation was perfect, really. Just basically all the navigation I just confirmed from the back, and he did all the flight. Absolutely perfect.
That's great to hear.
Good flight.
That's good to hear.
That's nice.
Well, to come in fourth, it has to be wonderful. There's nothing more I can say.
From my side as well, first race, exciting, and yeah, enjoyed it. I will be back definitely.
Yeah, so we have just landed 2022 PTAR. It was very, very windy conditions, also very bumpy, but we try to use the wind where we could on the long legs, and hopefully we're somewhere in the runnings.
It was a good race. We had some challenging weather, wind and all of that, but it was a good race.
think accuracy we would do there, but we struggled a bit with the speed, but otherwise I can't complain.
No, I agree with Yandre. It was really a challenging race for us. It was a long race. We were handicapped at 112.88, and you know, then we're getting close to a 3-hour race for 300 knots or so nautical miles. But we did very well with accuracy. Fantastic with accuracy. I think we can win this one with accuracy, but definitely not the overall. Our speed wasn't there. Thank you.
Thanks.
Had a fantastic trip up there. We beat everyone we wanted to, and three of us is always more fun than two.
So right, those cheaters at Charlie Hotel Charlie, clean them up, eh?
Yeah, this is our ground crew, Dan.
Dan's our ground crew, and Mary was
a passenger
in the back who was more than a navigator. She was an inspiration.
It was an absolute pleasure sitting in the back. I sat there, fat and happy, enjoyed the ride.
We had a terrific race. Wasn't too bumpy. Lost a bit of time on two legs. Came first in the average score.
Yeah, so a lot of headwinds when we were going south, and did lose a lot of time. Speed came right down, but all in all, it was a nice race.
Every single year, quite religiously, the local club steps up to the plate in a big way and supports their own events. They support their own teams that enter and their own club. And this year was no exception. I think the guys from this club did an amazing job putting sponsors together, working all hours of the night. I know some of the guys I saw photos were sitting on tractors until late at night, you know, 2-3 days ahead of time, just to make everything look beautiful, guys. Okay, as far as the sponsors go, it was quite tricky, but luckily we've got, like I said, local guys, and because I'm not a local, I had to write down all these names. The first company we'd like to thank, Diesel Tech Adco, they're local guys. It's really on technical consulting. And then Ford, is that Himans Auto? And obviously Twizza, the big sponsors, and thank you very much. Those are the local guys. And then the Bloemfontein Flying Club Committee, like I said earlier. And I'm going to try this. Mangaung Municipality, is that right? Is it close? Mangaung. Is that better? Okay. So thanks guys for the facility, obviously the airport. If there wasn't an airport, we couldn't do this. And then Marius, I know Marius put a lot of work into this behind the scenes as well, so thanks Marius, we appreciate it. In terms of sponsors go, we've got a handful of national guys that we can pull up in the last second. The first one is AFC, Aircraft Finance Corporation, then DJA, the guys you know very well, the short-term insurance. Century Avionics, they always pull up and help us make sure that you guys don't cheat too much. We accept a little bit of cheating, but not like all of it. And Holborn, which is obviously a big deal for us. You heard from them earlier with the jar. And they've come up massively as a gold sponsor, not only for the Presidents Trophy Year races, but also for the speed rallies throughout the entire year. So thanks again, Holborn. You guys really making a big difference to us. And then obviously Pilot Insure, and Pilot Insure.
Thank you, France.
And there's where Pilot Insure is also there.
Thank you,
Darwin. And the media guys, you know, I don't think we say thanks to the media enough. And we all know them, the African Pilot and Pilot's Post and Flight Line Weekly. You know, these guys also, they follow us throughout the country wherever we go, and really try and tell the message and get the message across of how much fun this is, the camaraderie between everyone. And I think we don't say thank you enough to the media guys, and I want us to give them a massive round of applause. I'd like to call up Leon Boutel, the chairman of SAFA.
Everybody's enjoying the evening as much as what I am.
Tonight we'd like to just talk a little bit about the PTAR going forward. Rob Jonkers has taken over a few years ago, probably an all-time low. Managed to revive the PTAR to a great event. I think everybody's had a wonderful weekend, and we look forward to this going forward in the future. Rob, at the end of this year, will be standing down. Ian will be taking over as the race director. Rob will still be around to assist in the background, and we look forward to an even better event going forward. And our next year's event, we've made some good arrangements and we've got some good plans, and I really think things are going to grow and go forward. David and France have made a brilliant effort with the marketing and the promotional side of things. This event, everybody knows about it, and I think I'm hoping we can look forward to something a lot better next year.
Okay, maybe this is a bit of a surprise for everybody.
Well, you too.
No, when I was sitting there, Ron looked at me shocked. Okay, look, when I took over as chairman of SAPFA in 2017, there were a lot of issues with the PTAR that happened in that particular year, that we had to start looking at recovering of how we are going to make the event into a, I'd say, into a fair event as best as what we could. So that I took on as a role. I think the committee decided on my behalf that I had to take up that role, and I've tried, I'd say, the best that I could over the last few years to get it to where it is today. And nothing is perfect, but we're always looking at evolving it, and I think that's the point. We need to evolve the sport. Just like most of you also follow something like Formula One. It keeps on evolving because there keeps on technology that is, that is breaking the boundaries of, of the sport, and there's no difference here either. There's been many difficulties over those last 3 years with the race changing the format. As I said, we will be looking at improving it as best we can, and we'll have the input from everybody that has taken part to do that. I'd also just like to thank Jonty. He's not here this evening, but between Jonty and myself, we developed the Speed Rallies, and that has given us a platform to develop ideas quickly. First year we had 6 events, and the second year we had, I think, 4 or 5, and then we had COVID, and that slowed everybody down, and then we at least got back into the swing of things last year. We were able to hold 4 events. And I'd just like to thank all the participants and supporters that have supported us in development of the sport over the last few years, because we as officials are not doing it for ourselves. I think maybe that is where the race went wrong many years ago. We as the officials want to make it the best for yourselves as the participants. So I'd just like to thank the club. We have 7 Aero Club centenary books that was written in the year of 2020, when all of us were doing nothing, that I'd just like to hand over to Andre, and he's nominated a number of his club members who would like to hand them out to me.
It's been extremely difficult taking guys from the past, current, so we have to honour a few of them. And on behalf of Cassie Castleman, who's been the race director many years, Johan van Groeten, currently Wally Goodrich, that was my right-hand man during the race, Dion Lewis, our current chairman, Clive Lowe, who's doing a sterling job, and then Rikus Berger, who's running that sterling clubhouse that you saw. On behalf of them, this evening, thank you so much.
The PTAR since 1937, first started out as the Governor General's Cup. Of course, the war year stopped a few things, and then it became the state president's air race in 1962. And then it changed to the President's Trophy air race, I think 1994. Not exactly sure of the date, but it's all there. And then the CAA, we have a good working relationship with this particular team of the CAA, Motiba, who works for Pierre Loebscher. They are always present at these kinds of events. And they see that things run smooth, they see to it that the event runs according to what we've applied for. Because the planning for this type of event takes 4 to 5 months. We already start in January with getting all the documentation in place to have this weekend happen. You know, it's from getting police clearances, municipality landowner approvals, getting the emergency services organized. Awards, there are four Cow Flying Association members that we have nominated to become honorary members of SAPFA. First one I'd like to call up is Walter Woolley. Yeah, so Walter has been a member for also many, many, many years.
Speech!
Hello. It's been a pleasure serving SAPFA.
Second one is Chris Boyson. So Chris unfortunately passed away last year, so this will be a posthumous award, an honorary member. And then also honorary member is going to be Chester Chandler. Yeah, all of you will know Chester very well. This is probably his first race that he hasn't attended. He did ask me to send his best regards to everybody, because I'm sure you will all miss him. Okay, and then the fourth one is Dirk De Vos. He's also been a long-standing supporter and campaigner, doing the difficult work of handicapping and scoring. I know that most of you are running with him at some point in your life. He's no longer involved with what we are doing, but we felt it good that we provide him with an honorary membership.
Airmanship goes to the pilots and crew of Zulu Sierra Echo Fox India. Please come up and let your pride. To the crew finishing under exceptional circumstances goes to, I think we can all agree on this one, Zulu Sierra, Mike Roman, Delta, Cessna Cardinal, Carol Blue, and Percy Rodman Senior. Well done, thank you.
Thank you.
to call Dion Lewis, the chairman of the Bloemfontein Flying Club, please to come up and collect this gift as a token of our appreciation for hosting the President's Trophy Air Race 2022. Thank you very much. I think the guy that shot him for speech must come forward. But to the winners tonight, and I think everybody is a winner, thank you very much. The club hosting this event, and the club members and the committee, great guys, thank you very much. It's really an honor to receive it on your behalf. And then for everyone else here, I mean, to start to thank everybody. I'm going to miss someone out, and I'm not going to be popular. But thanks again for the evening and bringing yourself to the Bloemfontein Flying Club. Hope to see you soon again.
I would like to call up Jock Nell, the chairman of a certain flying club, which we shall name Middelburg. Middelburg, why would the Middelburg Flying Club be here tonight, everybody? Because that's who is hosting the next President's Trophy Air Race 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, Jock Nell.
Look forward to honoring whatever has happened in the past, and we respect and acknowledge everybody that's been involved with this event. Back from 1937, it is like 85 years. So we have to be respectful of that. And we like to thank everybody that's been involved all along. We also ask that everybody contributes and guides us in terms of running the event next year. Thanks very much.
It's a major surprise. We know we had a good one, but I don't think we did it all the way, but I think we ran a good race. I think we kept our track tight. I think we pushed it hard, and so happy to do this, so happy to be here. Thanks a lot.